going. Look at the 88 picking himself up. Three one. Oh, we got trouble. Oh my God.
There's going to be a spider being pulled right here to the low side. Peter, he goes to the high side, does the bomb on the track. Side by side to the start finish line. They make contact, but it's the 12 of Keenan who's going to win it.
He goes under.
It's the apron.
Oh, no, the inside, three wide.
They all spin.
Bit of contact right behind. K3, yes, turn. Oh, the 77's on his roof.
Welcome everybody here live at Lime Rock Park here for the Lime Rock 30 Minute Sprint. My name is Zika Reyes, going to be your host here for tonight as well as an administrator for the league. And we're getting ourselves set up here to go dark racing, so it should be a lot of fun to see how all these drivers maneuver around the track without any lights. Of course. Me and the commentary booth here for tonight. We'll go ahead and pull up weather here as we get set. Coming here from Lime Rock. Temperature roaming around 77 degrees, humidity at 1%, going 4 miles per hour, southeast. Track information, it's the full course. Track length 1.47 miles in length, there's 4 turns. Track elevation roaming around 500 above sea level. Track temp currently at 77 degrees and nothing really much to say. It's too offset about this track. Otherwise, saying that this is the starting tracks that iRacing does give out. So I'm pretty sure a lot of people have some experience on this, in this track. But we got a lot of drivers here for tonight, as you can tell by the list. Still currently under qualifying conditions, people taking their laps in and around the racetrack. Currently watching the number 09, Connor Lane, making his return here in the 09. So I should go ahead and attempt to follow with him. Heads, I think, I don't even know what part is he on. I think he's on the back stretch. No, actually, he's coming into turn number one, so this is one and two. Apex varies on what, where you are. Turn two is tighter than turn one, so you're gonna have to get as wide of an arc in on the big bend. Heads through the left-hander and the right-hander. Sort of like an S, the S's on the, coming onto the no-name straight. And of course the uphill in turn number 5. Right up here, this is going to be our watching point on how everybody will fan out as they head up to the back straightaway. And the course of the downhill off in turn number 7. Lane, oh, sideways, is going to wreck it. So he'll be starting from, by the looks of it, dead last, unfortunately. Around 50. Just about a minute remains in practice as of right now. Of course, as the time ticks on, that sun will go ahead and hide itself under the earth. And we'll suddenly, of course, what you call it? As the sun winds down, track obviously, track brightness will wind itself down, and all you'll really see are headlights around the racetrack. So, should be a lot of fun on how these drivers maneuver in and around, especially in the dark. Otherwise, than that, getting getting set to go green. As on top will be that number 36 of Cam Edmund Train. He's trying to go three in a row, actually. So we'll go ahead and pull up the order here for tonight. 36 Cam Edmund, Anthony Burrows in the 62 alongside of him. Connor Branding, Jim Courtney. Two of the people who raced Monza last week. Garrett Pick making his first start here in the Road Series. Austin Johnson alongside of him. Jacob Tyler May also in here for tonight. Aiden Saunders, the, I think, 07. Kiloa Hankins, Alex Karpa. Gosh, I totally butchered that name. Oh no. Apologies, you're gonna have to tell me your last name, bud. Derek and Chase, Derek Smith, coming off a second place finish at Monza. He's looking to redeem himself after what happened there, coming in a one at Monza. Miller and Schaefer. Peter Kenny, Ryan Kwan, William Sheen, Connor Lane, Keaton Jones, Darius Dadgar, Brian Chirico, Joseph Castell going to round out row number 11. But here we go, coming to the green flag. Getting ourselves set up. Engines revving.
Green
flag. We're up and away here at Lime Rock. 32 laps going to be ran. And a nice start. Cam Ebbin as they head coming into turns number one. And hopefully everybody doesn't really misjudge the corner. Bit of sliding action right behind. We'll see what happens right behind. One car all the way to the apron. I mean, to the grass. That'd be Kiloa Hankins in the 72 as he merges back onto the racing surface. Three wide action as they head into the, I think, the SS portion. Look at everybody aligned straight as they work themselves off of the corner. Down to no name straight. Still Cam Ebbin holds the lead as they head up the uphill. And boy, will everybody even survive. By the looks of it, there'll be no. Oh, man. Nearly hitting that guardrail. I don't even know who that was, but that was a really close call. Oh, got one car up into the wall. That was the same car. They're still in a three-wide situation. Around goes that car. That'd be Garrett Pick in the 111. Get himself back a go. Hopefully nobody runs into him. She makes himself a bye. Meanwhile, up front, everybody's just about situated, I guess. Top four, just about pulling away. Connor Brandon in second place. Jonathan Schaefer out of the race. Costello out of the race. Keaton Jones did not start. So all of them having issues. Let's hit it with a go. Person who's running last on the lead lap as of right now is that number 99 of Peter Kenny. He's just roaming around trying to log as many laps as he can. Oh, and going wide, I think that was Connor Brandon in the number 92. And oh, Connor goes around and he takes out Austin Johnson with him. Oh my god. And Connor's day definitely done for. Wiped the 21 with him. Austin doesn't look like he picked up as much damage, but boy, he's getting swamped by now three-wide situation. Kiloa Hankins had a whip to the high side. They're looking still just about three-wide. Pretty sure that knocked the steering out of Austin Johnson's machine, but Connor Brennan is done for. It's just going to be a two-car battle. Or is it? Anthony Burrows had to really fight out Connor Brandon. And Aiden Saunders has moved himself into third place now. Now 16 cars left on the racetrack. People are DNF. Connor Brandon, Jonathan Schaefer, Jacob Tyler May, Nick Miller, and Joseph Costello. And boy, the track is getting dark. ourselves off the corner. Stello, don't know if he closed that time. We'll see once they cross the start-finish line on how it turns out. As you see, Aiden Saunders goes wide. What a save! Aiden Saunders is dead sideways off the final corner. Keeps it straight somehow. My goodness. Wow. What a move. Show drivers miles per hour. And looks like Burrows is actually a bit faster than Cam Ebbin. 1 mile per hour faster, so he should be gaining very slightly. So I have a lot of laps left in this race. Work off the uphill. Down to the final corners. And boy, oh, Burrows lost a bit of time that go around. Still, the gap is running around 1.9. These are the only two drivers that are running consistent laps. Here we go, the battle for third gonna go on. Jim Courtney, Derek Smith gonna go at each other. Looks like, oh, bit of contact there, and looks like Saunders is actually in the mix of that one. Saunders isn't gonna go around, unfortunately. He's gonna hit the outside wall, into the tire as he goes. We'll see if he can whip it straight. But boy, Saunders' day. Pretty sure the toe's knocked out of this car as well, so not looking well as of right now for him. Gonna merge himself back, or at least try to. Under the racing surface, but boy, oh, got another spinner. Off to the low side, I think that's Garrett Pick in the 111. You can hear the tires screaming as, oh my gosh! Derek Smith just about grazed the outside wall. Derek still running up top five. Started all the way in 11th. Definitely making progress. As well as Connor Lane, the 09. Jim Courtney is leading this trio. Now we've left ourselves with just about 13 cars on the racetrack. Cam took the corner just a slight bit wide. See if that affects him. And into the uphill. It's close. Maybe too close. I think that's Peter Kenny getting out of the way. Coming up on lap car. Oh, Kenny's actually into the inside wall. But, oh god, that dude's sideways. Don't know who that is. Oh, that's, well, that's a white car. Tirico is also off the track as well. Kenny's currently on the hill, trying to get himself back a go. Still stuck around there. Looks like I think it was Sheen. some Gargan's screen time. Dead into the inside wall he goes. Don't know if that is. But now that leaves us with just about, I'd say, 10 cars on the lead lap. Oh, Cam sideways. Had to correct it. He's about to go. And we'll... that'll allow Burrows to pull. The gap is less than a second now. Off the corner, Burrows just about hitting the outside wall. Man. Oh, Cam sideways. Burrows is also sideways. Cam keeps it on the track. He's going to attempt to break the draft now down the straightaway. Oh, boy. Vision issues definitely playing a factor as here comes Burrows. Going to go to the inside. Well, at least try to. Can't make anything happen. But will this be the pass for the eventual lead? We'll find out here in these next few corners coming up on No Name Straight and into the uphill. Burrow's going to use the outside. Cam on the inside going to go ahead and defend. Keep themselves straight. Boy, this is one heck of a battle for the lead. Head down the straightaway yet again. Cam all the way against the inside wall, attempting to break the draft. Burrows is still following in pursuit. Burrows definitely putting the pressure on him. We'll see if it makes a difference. Just head through the yeses and the right-handers, left and right-handers. Connor Lane. Now in second place, Derek M. Smith is following him in pursuit. Jim Courtney out of this mix. Ryan Kwan, Kiloa Hankins. Darius Rezadadgar also running top five. Brian Chirico in the eighth place. Alex, unfortunately, is on pit road. We'll see if he can get it back a go, but this is the only action we have on the racetrack after we all just wiped themselves out in the first 10 laps. Here we go yet again, that blocking. Or I'd say draft breaking. Showing strong. That should be a good view. After turns 3 and 4. Now onto the straightaway. We're going to the uphill. Burrows is putting the pressure. Now here he comes. To the inside of Cam Ebben. Can he clear him off? Trying to. Still side by side. They're going to be side by side into the downhill portion. Burrows sends it in. He's going to clear Cam. But here comes Cam yet again with a crossover to the inside. Is it enough? Who gets in the gears quicker? Cam to the inside. Sails it into the corner. Gonna retake the lead. Nice move. Yourselves off of two. Cam, that crossover has cleared Burrows by full car. I don't think it's done yet. Side by side into one. Will there be contact? Oh, bit of door banging. If this was open wheel, that'd be a different story. Burrows gets shoved out of the racetrack. But Cam takes the corner wide. Burrows goes to the lead. Burrow's gonna clear. As they head down the back straightaway. Onto the right hander. From the west bend and onto the downhill. Camry takes the lead somehow. Oh, Burrow's over the curbs. That's going to lose him a bit of time. These two are keep themselves hooked on each other by the looks of it. Oh, just about taking the corner wide. Coming up on the lap car, don't know who that is. I think that's, it's Dadgar in the number 11. Coming up on the 11, gonna take it wide and around they go to put Dario now two down. Dilawa Hankins is the only one down as of right now. Down the straightaway. Cam still in the lead. He's led 14 laps, except two. Bit of blinking going on. Those two, but Burrows is still keeping strong. Burrows' defining moment came at Sonoma. In the truck series, and he's proven tonight that he is a road racer. Here he comes the inside. Can he get Cam? By the looks of it, no. He is trying so hard. He's tried everything on Cam besides running into him. They go down no name straight again. Oh, Burrows goes wide. But he still keeps it with Cam. They go into one. I'm surprised all this battling up front hasn't allowed Connor Lane or Jim Courtney to pull. But if these two do have a problem. Oh boy. That lead will somehow be handed down to Connor Lane. And he has a good margin over Jim Courtney, the O24. Come up through the uphill. So close. Burrows a bit wide, takes it to the grass. Keeps it nice and steady though. And he's still with Cam. Here comes Burrows to the outside. Can't make anything happen. Open contact. Boy, Burrows just wants to get around Cam now. Oh, more contact. I saw a lot of contact being made between them both. Remember, Cam's trying to go three in a row. One is... More contact being made. Burrows just wants to get himself around Cam. Cam's been a huge holdup to that number 62. And he's finally letting him know, I want a round, and Cam takes the corner to the grass. This time, Biddle will be 10 laps to go. Whoa, Cam did not downshift well, and he got dead sideways coming into one. I am so surprised that Cam's still holding on to the lead. The corners fairly nicely. They have not been unskewed of each other ever since Cam lost it through the S's. Here they go again, coming into one. Burrows going to lay the bumper to Cam again. To the uphill. No difference. Cam attempting to block. Going to take the corner wide. Going to open up the door for Burrows to the right side. Can't make the move. These two are driving for their lives right now. Cam takes it to the grass off of 7 yet again. Both of them trying to break the draft. They're going to head into one. Cam still blinking in and out. I think that'll cause a problem for Burrows, as he's trying to whip around. Here comes Burrows yet again, right back at him. Is it gonna be enough? There's gonna be lap traffic ahead, but they'll come up with them on them on the straightaway. Thinks that the number 11, Darius Rezadadgar, currently running 8th place. Oh, did Cam just take the corner wide? I don't even know. Burrows. Yup. Oh my goodness. Burrows is in the grass. And I think that'll end the battle for the lead. He overshot it. We saw it off camera. And Burrows, that gap extends to 5 seconds. And Cam probably has a secure one. Or unless he might make it a show. Looks like he's going to be lifting for it. There's Burrows going to whip around. I guess Cam wants a show. And he'll have one. Look at the lap car. He's going to get into the way. Cam said he wanted a show. He went ahead and lifted. And Burrows goes ahead and whips it around. Probably lifted a bit too much. Now the gap is more than a second. You see Darius Rezadadgar. And I don't even know who that red car is. It's Brian, might be Brian Chirico or Lo Hankins or someone like that, but Cam wanted to show, and he's got one, but he has to make it in six laps for something to happen. Burrs up through the gears onto the uphill, both of them off track. Here comes Evan right back at him. Now where will Evan go? Oh, bit of contact. Oh, jeez. These two are going at it. None of them are giving room. Burrows up the track. Cam right back to the lead. On board with the 62 as he heads up through the gears. There's a helmet cam. Right through the uphill, and you see how the car just gets light. Burrows back to the inside. Can he make the pass happen? Evan. Not really. Burrows had the lift. Seven to 31. Five laps to go. What does Burrows have for Evan? We'll find out here in five laps. Evan takes the corner wide. Whoa, Ryan Kwan is sideways. Oh, nice save by Ryan Kwan off a four. I mean, off, not off a four, off a seven. Gets himself back a go. Gonna come down to four laps to go this time by. Both of them yet again off track. Just about see four laps to go as they head off the through the corners on through the uphill. Both of them have a limited amount of X's. Cam has nine, Burrows has 12. You see there, Burrows closed a lot on that final corner. Yet again on board with the 62. But Burrows right to the back bumper of that 36. They're actually coming up on a bit of lap traffic. Don't know who that is. Look how dark it is. You can barely see through into the other corner. So here they go. They're coming up on a lap car. Lap car gets out of the way, but a touch of the grass. That's normal. Get yourself a bit off track, that's fine. No, more people off track. Coming out of three laps to go. Both of them within a second of each other. Loa Hankins is actually going to pass Darius Dadgar. Dadgar has now on pit road. Derek M. Smith out of the race. Too many incidents on his part. Both of them in the grass. Both of them on equal incident points. This time by, we'll see two laps to go. It's going to be between Cam Ebben and Anthony Burrows. Through the downhill portion, Burrows sticks the corner wide. Ebben goes all the way to the inside wall. Go ahead, whip out the draft. Two laps to go. Burrows to the back bumper of that 36. Burrows. A nudge, a push. Keeps it straight. They're looking side by side into the uphill. Ebben is blinking out. Oh, Ebben could actually go to take the corner one into the wall goes Ebben! Ebben's up on his roof! Oh my god! Over the tires! And that will end the battle between the both. And unfortunately for Cam Ebben, I don't even know if he could find a way out. But Anthony Burrows, after a bit of blinking and miscommunication, Burrows is actually gonna take it to the checkered flag. Congratulations, Anthony Burrows is going to win it here at Lime Rock. Oh my goodness. What was two to go turned into one to go, and the white flag flew, and all bets were off as he went through the uphill. Me, oh my. That will be one for the record books. Congratulations to 62 of Burrows. Oh my goodness. Of course, this being a timed race, ATVO attempts to calculate on how much time is left in the race. In iRacing, the time expired on the white as they headed down the straightaway. And Burrows just took it into position as Cam Ebben was blinking in and out. Top 10 right in front of your screen. Karpowicz. Alex Karpowicz. In the 853, gonna round himself up 11th outside the top 10. And 21st, 22nd, right there. Keaton Jones did not start the race. So, we'll be back right after this. You're watching the Lime Rock 30 here for the iSCAR Road Series right here at Lime Rock Park. We'll be right back. course, if you're now just tuning us in for tonight, coming here live, now finishing up for the Lime Rock 30 for the iSCAR Road Series. And oh boy, what a finish we had. It was interesting, to say the least, but of course, our eventual winner rounds himself up and into victory lane he goes. Unfortunately, Burrows is not in the waiting room as of right now, so we're going to actually drag in our second place runner of Connor Lane. And Connor, you weren't in the midst of the battle with Cam Ebbin and Anthony Burrows, but you rounded yourself out in second after that final lap crash. Of course, a lot of things went on during that start. We couldn't cover everything there, but what? How was the car and how was the race out there today?
The car was the same as everybody else's, but it the setup's pretty good here. Lime Rock's always a fun track in these cars, but the race is pretty good. I think I started, I don't know where I started. I started 18th, so didn't qualify. Went in the race with no practice, basically joined right at the last minute. I definitely wasn't as fast as Anthony or Cam, but I think if I would have started up a little closer to the front, probably around top 5, top 6-ish, 8-ish area, I probably could have latched on and ran a little bit closer than what I was with them, but I was definitely not as fast as them, because they're really good at this stuff, and you can't take that away from them. I don't know what happened to Cam, which sucks for him. He definitely deserved first or second, but it was a good race overall. It was a little crazy the first couple of laps back there, but all in all, it was pretty good.
Yeah, speaking of the first couple of laps, what happened as you went through the field?
Oh, well, nothing really. Most of it, really, the seas parted ways. Like, the first lap, I think I picked up 3 positions before I even got to turn one. And then just crazy stuff happened. 72 cut me off because he came from the grass. Then the 9 car was letting me by. He probably let me by in the worst place possible and blamed it on me, saying I put him in the grass, but I really didn't. And then he got junked, so I don't know. After that, I really just drove to the field, just took my time, and it was a little dirty. I had a lot of incidents from off tracks and just like getting like little tiny 4Xs, which probably shouldn't have been 4Xs, but all in all, it was pretty good race.
Count, man. You finished out your night here in second place. Congratulations, man, on your second place finish. And he's want to thank for night's race.
Yeah, I'd like to thank Yacht Club Lounge Racing Motorsports Incorporated, Dale Earnhardt for teaching me how to race, and Scott's Grass for keeping the grass clean at Lime Rock.
All right, man. 10-4. Congratulations, Connor Lane, gonna round himself out second here tonight.
All right, thank you.
And that was the 09 of Connor Lane. And unfortunately, Cam Ebbin didn't finish outside the top 3, so we're not going to have him in the booth. Jim Courtney Naughton, as well as Anthony Burrows. But congratulations to your winner of Anthony Burrows in the number 62. We'll be back for the finale at Watkins Glen International Speedway. But until then, my name is Ezekiel Reyes. Yeah, not really much to say after that one. Thank you all for watching. Can't wait to tune in. Coming in. Can't wait for everybody to tune in. Coming next week.